Chapter 4, Steps to Success with Organic Gardening. If you have long been curious about organic gardening, you may now be familiar with how things are being done in this process. But even so, you must not tire out from learning new things to help you with this venture. It is important to keep yourself updated with how things are being done. You should be in tune with the local gardeners in your area so that you can talk things out with enthusiasts like you. If your goal in going organic in terms of gardening is to help nature, then you are on the right track. For sure, nature itself will find ways to help you out and for you to be able to see solutions to your problems just around the corner. This is how generous nature is. And this is also the basic idea of the organic process of gardening. It is to give back to nature what nature has bestowed you with. In gardening, you will have to veer away with synthetic materials. You only have to use what can be found on the ground or the environment around you. For example, in fertilizers, you have the option to make your own compost. But this is no easy task. Doing so will take a lot of effort and time on your part. The first method to go about this is to gather dried leaves, certain animal manure, vegetable peels and the likes on a compost bag. You have to attend to it periodically to add moisture once in a while and to make sure that you are doing things right. The second method is to pile up the materials that you have gathered on the ground. Pile those up in a space that you will allocate for your compost. You just leave them there and let nature take its course through those materials. Through time, years even, that pile will be turned into compost materials that you can also use as fertilizers for your garden. But you've got to be careful to choose only the part that is not infested with pests. If not, you'll have bigger problems with your garden. The latter method will take longer. And because it is open, and you cannot regulate it, certain elements can be accommodated into the pile which may be harmful to your garden. So, when you are already using that, you still have to check very closely so that you will retain your garden's health and beauty. You have to remember that you must be picky with your plants. Ask a local dealer what plants will grow easily on your location. You must not opt for something you like that will not survive the site's conditions. Learn the art of mulching. You have to do this periodically in your garden beds. This will kill the growing weeds. You'll be able to monitor the unnecessary pests and get rid of them. This also moderates the temperature of the soil. And by mulching it, you'll prevent the soil from eroding. Have a variety of plants in your garden. This way, you will be able to attract beneficial insects. These are the types that would feed on the pests that your garden may incur. And the most important thing to do in organic gardening is to befriend your plants. You must know all them fully well. This way, you will have an idea as to what to do in cases where a problem struck and you have no one to help you. Tips for organic vegetable gardening. Organic vegetable gardening is easy. But to help you, here are some tips you should know. The most important thing to do is to decide what you want to grow. There are so many vegetables to choose from, but keep in mind that certain vegetables cannot be grown because of the climate, so take that into consideration as well. So, you want to have a hard time taking care of it, choose those that are well adapted to the soil, temperature, sun, and shade exposure. If you live in an area where droughts are frequent, make sure you are planting drought-resistant vegetables since it does not eat up that much water and can withstand dry weather. You should determine how much space you have. This will make it easy for you to plot on a sheet of paper the layout of how you want your vegetables to grow. You should mulch your vegetables with organic material. This can be made from food waste, dead leaves, or grass and manure. This helps conserve water, adds humus and nutrients, as well as discourage weeds from growing. The best part is that you don't have to dig deep to put these in because 85% of the vegetables' roots are found in the top 6 inches of soil. Aside from compost, you can also use natural fertilizers and organic material to help the vegetables grow. They also encourage native earthworms that are nature's tillers and soil conditioners. The biggest threat that could destroy your vegetables are pests. To get rid of them, you should use other insects, birds, frogs. If your crops though have been infected, spray infected stems and leaves with dilute soapy water and then clear water that is very effective. If you decide to buy vegetables that are grown instead of using seedlings, most of these come in plastic containers. Be careful when you remove them, so you avoid tearing the outside roots, especially if these have grown solidly inside the container. When planting vegetables, don't stick with just one but plant many different kinds, because this invites insects to take up residence in your yard. Believe it or not, only 2% of the insects in the world are harmful. This means the rest are beneficial. Some examples of these include ladybugs, fireflies, green lacewings, praying mantis, spiders, and wasps, since they eat insects that try to eat your vegetables. Another thing they do is pollinate the plants and decompose organic matter. Don't forget to remove weeds that come out in your garden. You can pull these out by hand or spot spray it with a full strength of household vinegar. Best of all, it is safe for the environment. Practice crop rotation. This will make sure that the soil is always fertile. When planting the new vegetable, avoid regular deep cultivation, as this will damage the roots, dry out the soil, disturb healthy soil organisms, and bring weeds to the surface that will soon germinate. If you follow these tips, you will surely be able to have a successful organic vegetable garden. You can plant and harvest them all year round, so you don't have to buy these goods anymore from the supermarket. That is assuming, of course, you have a huge parcel of land to work with. Chapter 5: The Benefits of Eating Organically Grown Vegetables. If you have gone to the doctor, chances are he or she has told you to watch what you eat. If you have been eating the right amount of fish, meat, fruits, and vegetables, then you have nothing to worry about. But because some of these contain harmful chemicals, perhaps you should start switching to organically grown vegetables and other food products. Why should you buy organic food products? Simply because majority of these items have been genetically modified. Farmers have used various techniques, chemicals, and fertilizers to make them bigger, even if they know that this is dangerous to your health. No magic or anything fancy is used to make organically grown crops. You only need fertile soil, sunlight, water, and some compost to make it work. A recent study shows that following this simple plan helps vegetables have 50% more vitamins and minerals than those made from conventional methods. If you eat them regularly, you are able to have a healthier life. You will probably feel like you will live longer too, as organically grown vegetables taste much better. This is because although fertilizers and pesticides have their advantages, they remove essential vitamins and nutrients, so you are not getting the required daily allowance that your body needs. In short, you may think you are, but in reality, this isn't what's happening. Another benefit of eating organic vegetables and food is that you help the environment. This happens because farmers will no longer use harmful chemicals and put these into the ground. The land which they have worked on can be planted by the next generation, because the land that has been cultivated for so long is still fertile. When you go to the supermarket, one thing you will notice is that the price of organically grown vegetables and other items are much more expensive than those conventionally grown. Should you always buy something if it is cheaper? In the case of food, the answer is no, because you can't put a price on the lives of those who eat it. Surely, you also don't want to wait until someone you know gets sick, so think about the future and go organic. Eventually, the price of organic items will go down when more farmers decide to sell these in supermarkets. It is only because there is a small section of this available now in the store, but when it becomes an industry standard, things will change. Until that happens, you can probably plant and grow these in your backyard. You just need the supplies, especially the seeds or the fully grown plant, to help you get started. Don't forget to do some research first, so you know how to take care of them. After all, sprinkling water every morning is just one of the many things you have to do to help this grow. Perhaps one of the biggest challenges in organic food is that the US imports a lot of vegetables from countries that are not yet practicing this back to the basics method. But with a little help and encouragement, they too will come around, so everyone not only here but in other countries as well will be able to enjoy the benefits of organically grown vegetables and fruits. Organic vegetable gardening is the way to go. In the US, farming is a $6 billion industry. To keep it that way, and with the health and welfare of the public in mind, the Department of Agriculture has taken steps so farmers can shift to organic farming. This does not only save money, but also has some health benefits. But first, we have to know what organic farming is. This is a technique that has been practiced by ancient civilizations that simply relied on the land they worked on, the sun, and the water to make the harvests grow. It was only when scientists invented fertilizers and pesticides that we moved away from this technique, because it was thought that this will make the crops bigger and harvesting faster.
Unfortunately, the use of fertilizers and pesticides has done more harm than good.
The chemicals used are harmful, but never in small dosages. But imagine what if somebody consumes this in excessive amounts and unknowingly develops an illness or their baby has birth defects. Such threats are real, which is why we have to do something before it happens. Before the Department of Agriculture wanted everyone to go into organic farming, tests were conducted. The results show that organically grown vegetables have more nutrients and vitamins compared to conventional farming.
The same goes for its taste.
Organic vegetables do not have hydrogenated fats, artificial flavor or coloring, sweeteners, additives, preservatives or residual antibiotics. This means that what you get is all natural. But don't forget to wash these first before it is cooked to remove any residue from the compost used in helping it grow.
The government or the Department of Agriculture is not the only one who should push farmers to shift towards organic farming.
You can do your share by talking to the farmers themselves, as they are the ones who plant them. You can also start planting organically grown vegetables yourself, because they cost a bit more in the supermarket. Before you start planting, check how big is the area so you have an idea what kind of vegetables can be planted given your limited space. You then need to buy the necessary tools and make some of them yourself. This information can be found online, in books, and from the gardening store. If you don't want to start making an organic vegetable garden using seeds, you can get starter plants instead, but be aware that they cost a bit more and this takes the thrill out of gardening. But if money is no object to you, by all means get this from the store. Just make sure that there is a stamp which certifies that this has been approved by the Department of Health, Quality Assurance International, California Certified Organic Farmers, or the Oregon Tilth Farm Verified Organic.
If everyone does their share, no one will use chemicals and fertilizers anymore. Everyone can live healthy and eat healthy.
At the same time, we are able to protect the environment so future generations will be able to use the land we have used to plant their crops in the future.
Organic vegetable gardening is truly the way to go. If you noticed, some restaurants have done their share as well by making people know that whatever they use is organic.
Chapter 6: Organic Vegetable Gardening So Important These Days. Organic vegetable gardening seems to be the trend these days as more people have become conscious of what they are eating.
This is because conventional methods which involve the use of harmful chemicals may enter our systems.
In order to control the problem, the U.S. Department of Agriculture has issued a new directive.
This encourages farmers to shift to organic farming. With organic farming, farmers will no longer need to plant crops using genetic engineering, irradiation, and sewage sludge. Instead, this will be replaced with crop rotation. Crop rotation is the practice of planting a different crop in the same area where another crop once occupied.
This keeps the soil's nutrients fertile, so it can be used again in the following season. If you think about it, this approach is easier said than done, as farmers are accustomed to the old ways of doing it. To help them change their minds, the government offers incentives and subsidies to farmers who decide to follow this plan. But the main reason why organic vegetable gardening is so important is the fact that the crops harvested have 50% more nutrients and vitamins compared to that of conventional farming methods. This means the food they consume will reduce the risk of people suffering from a number of diseases like diabetes, high blood pressure, heart disease, and certain cancers. Children who drink milk will be able to get more antioxidants, CLA, omega-3 and vitamins when this is extracted from pastured grazed cows that will really strengthen their bones and muscles. You can buy organically grown vegetables from the supermarket. The sad part is that almost everywhere you go, although the packaging comes from Department of Health, Quality Assurance International, California Certified Organic Farmers, or the Oregon Tilth Farm Verified Organic, most of these are only 50% to 70% organic. This is why homeowners who want to eat 100% organic vegetables are encouraged to grow these themselves.
There are two ways to make this happen. First, you buy the seedlings until they grow so you can harvest them. Second, you buy them fully grown and then just plant it into the ground.
Most people prefer the first because it makes them proud to know that what is served on the table was done from scratch. In both cases, you have to prepare the soil, use compost, and make sure that these are safe from threats such as insects, weeds, and other animals that will eat what you have planted. You can fight these with other animals, insects, organic fertilizers, deodorant soap, and a few other items which you can find out after doing some research. For those who don't have a big garden, they can try growing these organically grown vegetables in containers. They require more water than those planted in the soil, so give doses frequently. There is no doubt that organic vegetables and other products are important these days. If you value your health and those of your family, you can buy these from the store or plant it yourself. For those who decide to buy organically grown vegetables, remember to wash before cooking them. This will remove any harmful substances or residue that may still be there, which is invisible to the naked eye. Why should farmers practice organic vegetable gardening? Organic vegetable gardening has many advantages than conventional farming methods. This article will discuss that in the hopes that more people will realize that it has a lot of health benefits. First, organic vegetable gardening does not use any fertilizers or pesticides. The ingredients used in making these products are harmful to humans, and though they have been washed, people are still at risk of absorbing them when they are eaten. A study shows that organically grown vegetables have 50% more nutrients and vitamins. This means that you are lesser at risk of developing certain health problems such as heart disease, high blood pressure, diabetes, and cancer. Also, organically grown vegetables taste much better because it is not tainted with antibiotics. Think of it like powdered juice versus the kind that is naturally squeezed. The first one is mixed with a lot of artificial ingredients, while the other is straight from the source. It should be pointed out that fertilizers and pesticides make the soil unfertile. If this happens, we don't get the right number of vitamins and nutrients from the vegetables we consume. If this is true, why did people use fertilizers and chemicals? Because back then, the use of such methods was thought to help increase food production, but studies later on have showed there was a flaw, which is why this is being corrected. You can easily spot organically grown vegetables and other food items in the grocery as they are placed in a separate area. You will notice that compared to other products, they cost a bit more, but don't you think it is better to buy such products that are healthier? Organic farming is not only practiced for vegetables. This is also being done for fruits and animal livestock, as well as research has showed that milk from organic cows contain more antioxidants, CLA, omega-3 and vitamins compared to those that use hormones, antibiotics, and the remains of other animals. Given that, people should pressure their government representatives and even those who have not yet shifted towards organic farming to do so immediately. The government, for its part, has done their part by offering incentives and subsidies to farmers in exchange for no longer using genetic engineering, irradiation, and sewage sludge. This changes how the game is played, because the goal here is sustainable development, and the only way to make sure the soil used is always fertile is through crop rotation. This means planting one variant this season and changing it with another in the next, and so forth. It isn't hard to implement. Farmers just need the willpower to open their minds and make the change. You can also get into organic vegetable farming yourself by doing this in your own backyard. You just need to buy the supplies, prepare the land, protect it from insects and other threats so you will be able to harvest it in the next few weeks. Whenever you buy organically grown vegetables, don't forget to wash them before it is cooked. Although it is chemical-free, you don't know what kind of compost was used to help it grow. You hit two birds with one stone when farmers and you decide to go into organic vegetable farming. It keeps both the people and the environment healthy. Chapter 7, Feeding the Soil, One Vital Aspect of Organic Gardening. There is an important aspect of organic gardening that you can very well relate to. Imagine this. You are hungry. You haven't been fed. You haven't taken a bath. You haven't pampered yourself. You've spent so much time working and taking care of others, but you haven't tended yourself for your own good. How would you feel? For a time being, you may be able to accept the fact. You may still tire yourself out without asking for anything in return. But as the days go by, you will feel the negative effects of the situation. You will no longer have the kind of energy that you used to. Your body will deteriorate until it can no longer function for the things that it used to do. How is this related to the organic method of gardening? You can actually compare this to the state of the soil. Soil is a very important aspect in this type and all the other kinds of gardening.
This is the base of everything. This will be the bed, or the house of your plants. You must choose the right one in the first place. Depending on your location, the soils that you may acquire vary on such factor. You should base the decision in picking out the plants on the types of soils that are available in your area. Once you have picked the right kind, you are now on your way to the first steps of your gardening venture using the organic method. Relating to the sample above, the soil must never be left untended. It must never go hungry. Or else, what happened to the example may also happen to the soil. You have to feed the soil. You have to bathe it. And you have to take care of it just like how you tend to yourself or to the plants situated on your garden. You may know from your grade school days that the soil needs water, sunlight, and air. But you are doing everything organically now. Does it carry out any differences? Yes, a lot. Although you still have to feed your soil and the plants on its enough sunlight, water, and air, you have to add something else. You've got to have organic matters placed on the soil. Have you ever heard of composting? This is the process where you culminate decaying matters like leaves, grasses, peelings of fruits or vegetables, even manures and fish heads to act as your soil's fertilizer. This is organic, remember? You cannot resort to anything synthetic. This is one proof that this process entails a lot of hard work than you can ever imagine. Not only are you going to feed the soil, you also have to attend to it regularly. Mulching is like massaging the soil to keep its shape. This way, you will be able to get rid of the pests that your soil has gotten through the days or months, however long you have been gardening. This will actually help you prevent acquiring bigger problems. There are many types of soils that need certain care and attention. For example, clay can hold up water better than the sandy kind. You have to know those kinds of details to be able to improve on your organic gardening venture. 3 tips for organic gardening soil. Do you really think organic gardening soil is the same as regular garden soil? If so, boy, are you sadly mistaken and you have a rude awakening coming your way. That's kind of blunt, isn't it? Did I get your attention? I really hope so. The information in this article will help you get a better understanding of the facts about organic gardening soil. The first misconception most new organic gardeners have about their soil is that anything can grow in any type of soil. All you have to do is throw a few seeds in the ground and boom, you have a natural garden. You need to lose that preconceived notion if it applies to you. You must take into consideration the overall climate conditions which will impact the soil. An example of these things would be rain, wind, temperatures, and exposure to the sunlight. Then the next thing to consider is the amount of rocks and density of the soil. An example of bad density soil would be where the dirt is tightly compacted and allows for no circulation of air or moisture. To have good organic gardening soil, it must be loose, with excellent air and moisture circulation. Not to worry though, because one of the things you can do if your dirt is tightly compacted is introduce earthworms to the ground and allow them to do their thing. Frankly though, the earthworms take time to create their magic and they have a tendency to get out of the designated planting area quickly. However, there is a simple solution to that problem and you will help improve your soil quickly. You can go to your local nursery or hardware store and purchase organic soil by the bag full or even by the truckload. Many organic gardeners will put this soil on top of their compacted soil and then plow it into the regular soil. However, for this method to be effective, you must have enough organic soil to be from a minimum depth of 3 inches up to 6 inches or more. The great thing about it is, as you repeat this procedure through several growing seasons, you will soon have brought the life back to your original soil. Another tip about your soil is the proper levels of phosphates, hydrogen, and acidity in the soil. This is oftentimes referred to as the pH factor in the soil. It's quite easy today to go on the world wide web and order a testing kit for your soil. However, one of the best ways to determine if you have right kind of soil for organic gardening is to take a sample of your soil to your county agriculture agent or to your local nursery. For a small fee or no fee at all, they will tell you everything you need to know about your soil. In addition to providing you the information about your dirt, they can also advise you as to the best type of plants that will grow in your soil. Furthermore, they are a great source for additional tips on growing an organic garden successfully.
These tips are just a few of the things about your organic gardening soil which are important. To really get ahead of the game on your soil, you should continue to further your education.
Conclusion. Organic vegetable gardening is making a comeback.
This is because people are more health conscious about the food they eat, and in some places, there is already a food shortage, so some have decided to plant and grow these on their own. To help you get started, here is some organic vegetable gardening information. Organic vegetable gardening does not use fertilizers and chemicals which can be harmful to humans.
It also does not use genetic engineering or irradiation.
Instead, it uses simple farming techniques like tilling the land, giving it enough water and sufficient exposure from the sun. When harvesting is finished, something new is planted, which is better known as crop rotation, that helps keep the soil fertile.
Growing organic vegetables is not something that only farmers can do.
This can be done by homeowners, since they can plant some of these in their own backyard.
The first thing that you have to do is choose what kind of vegetables you want to grow.
You also have to understand how big these can grow, so it will be easy to plot how many can be placed per row.
The next step is to check the condition of the soil. There are kits you can buy from the store to check its fertility.
If the soil is good, then you can start by clearing it of rocks and weeds by mowing, pulling, or digging them out. You should then add compost, bone meal or rock phosphate, and greensand to the soil to supply it with nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. You can also add lime or sulfur to adjust the soil's pH level, only if you have to.
It will also be a good idea to till or dig in fertilizers using organic matter.
This must at least be an inch of sharp sand if the soil you have is made of clay, and then you rake the soil into beds and rows. You should leave it be for at least a month before you start planting.
Don't forget to use organic mulch to blanket the garden.
You can use ground bark for that, since it will decompose over a season or two. You can also use a compost pile made out of recycled leaves, grass clippings, coffee grounds, eggshells, and kitchen waste, since these serve as a good fertilizer. The organic vegetable garden will grow, but it will be always under threat from weeds and insects.
For that, you have to use other animals and insects to fight these pests. You don't have to buy them, because setting the ideal conditions will invite them into your home.
As for the weeds, you can get rid of them by pulling them out or spraying homemade vinegar, as this stops them growing.
If you plant thickly enough, you will be able to discourage weeds from growing in between the plants.
Planting your own organic vegetable garden isn't that bad, given that the only ones who will be consuming what is planted are those that live in the household. But it's going to be a bed of roses from the time you till the land to the time that they will be harvested.
The advantage of working on a small space is that you can easily inspect the whole area, so nothing is left behind.
Organic vegetable garden basics.
It doesn't take a rocket scientist to plant vegetables.
But if you want to do this the old-fashioned way, which has been proven to be very effective, you should know the organic vegetable gardening basics.
The first thing you have to know is, what is organic vegetable gardening? It is simply a way of farming that does not use any synthetic products, which includes fertilizers and pesticides. In short, you work with nature to get what you want.
When choosing the right vegetable to plant is knowing which of these are suitable to the soil and the climate. If you live in an area that experiences droughts, by those that do not consume that much water. Before you drop seeds into the soil, make sure the land is ready by tilling the land so it is clear both of rocks and weeds. The next step will be to add compost, bone meal or rock phosphate, and greensand to the soil to supply it with nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. If the pH level of the soil is too high, add lime or sulfur to adjust it. One more thing you have to do before planting the seeds is putting in organic fertilizer. You can use recycled leaves, grass clippings, coffee grounds, eggshells, and kitchen waste, which should be applied a month before planting begins.
Then it is time to plant the seeds.
Each seed must be spaced by a certain distance. The roots do not fight for water. In between each of the vegetables, you can plant other things as well, because the tighter the space, the lesser the chances that weeds will grow. Pests are the biggest threat to your organic garden.
To fight them, you can use birds, frogs, or other insects. You don't have these creatures to fend off other insects. You simply have to create the ideal environment by putting a birdhouse or a small pond.
Once they are in place, they will do the rest by patrolling your garden and eating those who seek to eat your crops. Putting up a few barriers can also help.
Row covers are known to prevent moths from landing and laying eggs. You can also use sticky traps and foil collars to stop pests and borers.
There are also organic pesticides around, but some of them can only kill one or two kinds of pests.
So, before you buy them, make sure you know what you are dealing with.
Crop rotation is the best way to preserve the fertility of the soil.
This is done after you harvest the vegetables, so it is ready for planting once again.
For this to work, you have to plant in the same area a different vegetable. Anyone can learn organic vegetable gardening basics and soon have their own little farm in their backyard. It is fresh, and you can pick this anytime you want, which is very convenient as these are only a few feet from your home.
Should everyone get into organic vegetable gardening?
Perhaps because there is a food shortage right now and most of the vegetables imported do not use this technique. The government, for its part, has given incentives to farmers here to shift to this method, but it's going to take more effort to persuade countries that do business with the US to do the same thing.